Welcome back to Mayor's Minutes. And today we have Bob Courtney in with us. He's going to be telling us some things about Madison, Indiana. So,
hi, Debbie. Thank you for having us again. It's been a few weeks since we were able to chat about what's going on in the mayor's office and City Hall.
And that's with all the COVID-19 going on. We've tried to be responsible.
Do our
social distancing.
I'm glad we're able to finally get back live and not do this call, frankly, over a Zoom call.
It's not quite the same thing. You don't have the same interaction.
Right.
So it makes a difference. I like it better this way.
So
we're here today and we're going to talk about mobilizing Madison, Indiana. And
That's
the city.
Right.
It's not the county.
That's right. So for the past 2 months, we have been significantly invested in the coronavirus response and its impact on our community. Initially, a lot of the conversation was about the public health emergency and how do we safely move about, and more importantly, how do we, stop the spread of the virus. And so we have been participating with Jefferson County EMA, Jefferson County Commissioners, the Health Department, King's Daughters Hospital, State of Indiana, Indiana State Department of Health, a lot of different first responders, so to speak, on how do we bring a resolution to our community and deal with this public health crisis. So that's what we've been spending the last couple of months on. And then over the last couple of weeks, it's really started to transition into, as our data is coming in and our community has responded very well to helping contain the virus through their personal efforts and choices, we're now moving into the next stage of our response efforts, which is about reopening our economy and working with Governor Holcomb on putting together plans at the state level and then implementing those statewide plans to Madison, Indiana. And that's what Mobilize Madison has been all about.
That is awesome. And so, and there's a lot of people involved in that. It's not just a couple. There's a lot of people involved in doing that.
Right. It's a citywide initiative, and we knew early on that as we were progressing through the public health emergency, what was going to be on the heels of it was going to be the economic crisis. And so as businesses were starting to shut down because of the stay-at-home orders that Governor Holcomb issued a couple of months ago, people were displaced. We had small business people, owners, hospitality workers, employees in our manufacturing and other industries across our community who were displaced. And so Mobilize Madison has really been a comprehensive approach to deal with that. And we did it in a number of ways.
So with all of that, you've got a plan for back on track.
Mm-hmm.
So how does that affect the city of Madison?
Well, it is. It now adds another layer to the coronavirus response effort. We still are tracking very closely the public health crisis elements of it. And so we need to make sure that we have really good, safe protocols in place as people regain their freedom of mobility, for example, and the travel restrictions have been lifted. We need to make sure that they're still using good decisions and social distancing and following CDC guidelines. And if you're an individual with some type of health issue or a high risk group, for example, you need to be extra cautious in making sure that you are continuing to follow stay-at-home restrictions. But for the majority of the community, they are free to move around, free to engage in commerce, free to go through different types of recreation out in the community. But we want to make sure people do that safely. So the next stage of this response is about reopening our economy using the back on track guidelines that Governor Holcomb had outlined. And there's five stages to it. And we're in the second week of the second stage of back on track. Now, there are still three more stages we have to get through,
right.
And this is a data-driven, evidence-based model. So it's not guaranteed that we get to stage 3, 4, and 5. So we have to continue to be diligent and work together as a community to make sure that our health and safety numbers stay positive. The trends are very positive, but we also need to make sure that we do what we can to continue to mitigate the risk that the virus expands in our community. So we've got a plan in place. Part of Mobilize Madison is about what can we do to safely reopen Madison, help facilitate reprisal of our economy here. Right now we're suffering from almost 25% unemployment. But as we progress through these different stages and small businesses are allowed to open, Restaurants are allowed to open at a certain capacity. Your personal service businesses are allowed to open. That's going to be a good barometer on to see how we're handling getting re-engaged in the economy, but still keeping, you know, the healthcare crisis at bay. And if we are successful, we'll be continue to progress through to stages three, four, and five, where all of our businesses will be open, crowd sizes get increased, social distancing is going to be with us, you know, in the near future for sure. But at least we'll get some of our personal freedoms back, and we can do it safely. That's going to be the key.
That's great. Now, with all of that, you've got an economic development plan that follows along with all this that has to be done.
Right. So when I came into office back in October, we immediately started working on economic development strategies. And at the beginning of the year, once we reorganized our economic development platform, you know, we were already working on some very ambitious economic development goals. Over the course of the past 2 months, I would say that even though we're spending a substantial amount of time dealing with the coronavirus response, we've never stopped working on our economic development initiatives. And they've been really successful. We're continuing to work on our shopping center redevelopment at the corner of Clifty and Michigan. That's going to be one of the largest injections of private capital Madison has ever seen. Mm-hmm. We rolled out last week an expanded PACE program. And the beauty of that is we are going to have a targeted revitalization focus on our neighborhoods, downtown and on the hilltop. And we are funding it at a level that's never been funded before. It's going to be the largest PACE program with the expanded mission that it's going to have. And what it's going to do, it's going to save some of the most dilapidated structures that have been allowed to exist in downtown Madison. And what we're going to do is target those. We've created a very, very substantial incentive. And I'm really grateful for two things. I'm grateful for those committee members who have stepped up to serve on the PACE Grant Committee, as well as certainly county commissioners who are helping us fund this program, county council, redevelopment commission, everybody who has been involved as a stakeholder in bringing redevelopment to our neighborhoods. That's a key for us. You know, we had to change out a couple of members on our PACE committee, frankly, in order to accomplish this. But those members who have stepped up, and I personally want to also thank Bill Ohlendorf. He said it best, that this is a program that's going to work for downtown Madison. And we're going to essentially take some of those most dilapidated structures that have been burned up, boarded up, and abandoned for a decade or longer. And we're going to attract private capital investment. And then those are going to be inhabited, tax-paying properties again that actually creates a lot of benefit to those neighborhoods. So that's one thing that just happened. And then we also just finalized the execution of a really comprehensive interlocal agreement with Jefferson County. And there are three or four things that are fantastic about that. One is the most comprehensive agreement between the City of Madison and Jefferson County that's ever been executed. But it does way more than any other agreement before. Working together, we're going to be bringing drug treatment solutions to the new Jefferson County Jail. We are also partnering on our historic preservation and economic development activities. Again, bringing the city and the county together, say, you know what, we're one community, let's work together better. Right. And then we're also, because of that partnership, able to keep the taxes lower for all of the residents of Jefferson County. So that was also a key driver when myself, Commissioner Bramer, and everybody who was involved in helping us bring that agreement to fruition, there were several key initiatives embedded into that one document. And I'm just really happy that we still have a lot of work to do, but at least the boundaries of that document, the financial aspects of the document have all been finalized. And now it's about execution. And what we're bringing to the table are intentional outcomes. That's something we've talked about a lot mm-hmm. with this administration. It's about being intentional, using data, and making a difference so that we can be impactful all across our neighborhood. So a couple of really, really good things that really, on top of the coronavirus, we're reopening our economy and bringing money and, like I said, private capital investment to our community.
I think that's great, because if you don't have a plan, you can't be successful.
Right.
So the fact that you all are putting together all these plans and making sure you're focusing on them and you're looking at data to make them work.
We spent a lot of time at City Hall talking about visioning. And it is about what is our vision, and then we take that vision and we collect the data. We take that data and we create information from it. And then we use that information to make data-driven decisions mm-hmm. that then becomes a strategy. And now we've got a roadmap to get us from point A to point B. We try to be intentional, like I said, with those types of initiatives. And we're already checking the box off on several key initiatives. And it's about being focused. And it's also about having a team that's on board. And I'm really grateful for all the team members, and the city staff and employees are exceptional. Right. The work that they've done, the dedication that they've done for our community during these most difficult times only proves that over the course of the next 3.5 years, it's just going to get better and better.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now we're going to back up a little bit to the historical downtown Madison. I don't think a lot of people understand why it's important to have the PACE program and fixing these old buildings and stuff. What is Madison, Indiana? How many blocks are there that are historical, and how does that affect?
Wow, well, Madison is one of the largest contiguous historic districts in the country, all with fantastic examples of 19th century architecture. Now, unfortunately, over time, blight has crept in.
Yes.
And there's also been some tragedies as a result of fires or decay and deterioration of a structure because it's not being maintained. You know, and the approach that we wanted to take is, let's not drive by it every day and pretend that it doesn't exist, or drive by it and fool ourselves to think that that isn't blight and that for some reason it's not detracting from the rest of the neighborhood. Let's do something about it.
Yes.
And so we talked a long time about, we've got to have these incentives. It's one thing for the city of Madison to have ordinances where they can take someone to court and enforce someone to do it, and hopefully have an outcome that way only after you've exhausted the legal channels. We said, let's create partnerships.
Yes.
When you have partnerships, you have the right incentives, you have the right focus, you can bring that capital in as a public-private partnership. And that is what's going to make the difference. And, you know, this is not an administration where blight is right. And it's not an administration either where we want to go around town and demolish structures. What we're going to do with more money than the PACE program has ever had before is be more focused than ever before, but also be more impactful than ever before in preserving these structures.
Right.
So on Tuesday night's PACE committee, they approved 18 applications, which was the largest they ever approved in one application period. Now we're taking those applications to the Board of Public Works, and for this one quarter's funding will be more than ever before in a quarter. And we're actually putting more money in the PACE program this year than in the last 6 years of the program. And so, again, our focus here is to be impactful. And I'm pretty passionate about it because I grew up on Walnut Street in the Historic District. I lived downtown in the Historic District. I worked downtown in the Historic District. But the Historic District has meaning to the entire part of Madison.
Yes.
You know, it brings tourists in both for the downtown and the hilltop. It's the one thing that Madison is really well known for nationally, and it's the most beautiful backdrop for all of the other economic development and tourist activities that we want to have in our community. And it's also a way to attract people to relocate here. So we had to change the way we approached those structures, and I believe the community is well behind us on this. City Council unanimously approved our ordinance and our targeted revitalization resolutions. Jefferson County Commissioners unanimously approved it. The County Council unanimously approved it. And so I think that we have a mandate. We have a mandate to do what's been neglected, and we're going to take action to get it done.
Well, the downtown district, the historical buildings, are very vital to Jefferson County, because people are coming into the county to visit and look at those buildings, and or to stay over the night, or, you know, come in and take photos. It's important that
Sure. In many regards, I mean, this is the gateway into Jefferson County.
Yes.
When you come across the bridge from Milton, Kentucky, you're entering the gateway of Jefferson County. Mm-hmm. You're entering the gateway of the city of Madison. And, you know, a lot of state highways lead into Jefferson County mm-hmm. and eventually lead into the city of Madison. And we also have a belief that bigger, bolder, better is an approach. Clean, safe, and beautiful is really how we operate. And
yes.
So you'll see one of the Mobilize Madison initiatives was about beautification. You know, what can we do to make Madison more beautiful than it's ever been before? And that's where I think the city staff and employees, they've all taken on personal responsibility to make sure that we are best in class in everything. And that's why we're going through these different initiatives very methodically, because we are thriving on a culture of excellence and a culture where the bar has been raised. And I think that the city of Madison should be really grateful for all the employees and who work so hard, A, to keep our community safe. Coincidentally, this is Police Appreciation Week, so
yes.
we're doing better than ever, in my opinion, with our community safety initiatives under the leadership of Chief John Wallace and fantastic department there. It's going in a great direction. And the beautification thing, the economic development, community safety, those are pillars of our administration. And economic opportunity, too, with our jobs program and part of that Mobilizing Madison. We're doing it all as well in a very transparent way. So we're communicating more than ever with the community. And I think on average, we have probably between 8,000 and 9,000 hits on our social media pages. And we have adopted some new practices with our public meetings that will continue even when we get back to doing in-person mm-hmm. Public meetings. So there have been some good things that we've been able to identify that will remain as best practices as we progress out of this emergency.
Right.
And I do want to emphasize again, we're also taking the right precautions to be safe. All of our employees have been healthy. We've not suspended any services during the COVID response. In fact, we've added services. We've added processes. We've done things where, frankly, we've led the state in some of our initiatives. And we have an office full of people with great ideas.
Mm-hmm.
And there's great ideas happening all across our community.
Right.
And they come to us and they want us to partner with them. And that's what it's all about, is creating these fantastic partnerships, because a lot of the hard work being done citywide and countywide isn't just with the county officials or the city officials or those employees. It's all the businesses, the nonprofits, the volunteers, the different social service agencies who are all working so hard to care so much about Madison. And all that does is reemphasize that the quality of life in Madison, Indiana is unparalleled anywhere else in the world.
Yeah. Well, it's great, because if you're open to people bringing in their ideas, sometimes there's a solution you didn't know about or your staff didn't know about, but if you're not open to somebody walking in and telling you something, it doesn't happen. And that speaks loudly of you and your staff, because you allow people to come in and give you their opinion and you learn more that way.
Well, it allows us to leverage what we have.
Mm-hmm.
We're leveraging our intellectual capacity to think about things, plan things, do things bigger and broader. We're leveraging our financial capacity with public-private money. It's not just about spending, you know, our precious tax dollars, for mm-hmm. example. It's about how do we create incentives in there so that we can take our tax dollars and quadruple them, for example, and have that multiplier effect through this public and private partnership. And so, you know, that's one way to look at it, is that we are leveraging all of our resources, whether they be intellectual or financial.
Right. Well, let's make sure everybody understands where they can find all kinds of resources. You have a site where they can go and they can find the resources for Back on Track,
right,
for the city, job opportunities and all that. So tell everybody a little bit about.
Well, as we continue to broaden the scope of city government and the initiatives, Hannah Fagan, who's our community relations director, has done a fantastic job working with her team in order to expand our City of Madison website so that it is a resource portal We have a COVID-19 resource portal in there. We have our targeted jobs program outlined there. A lot of local information, either whether it's coming from Madison Main Street or the Chamber of Commerce or the state of Indiana, for example, is deposited, and it really becomes a resource website that's more informative. Plus, all of the information that all of the essential boards and committees are continuing to work on is also posted so that anybody can review that and comment and send a comment either to myself or one of those board members and have it brought into the record. And then in addition, we are just doing so much more with our social media presence. If someone says that they don't know what's going on in Madison,
they have not got a laptop or desktop or an iPhone.
we just need to remind them, look at the City of Madison, Indiana Facebook page.
Yes.
Look at the City of Madison website. Look at the mayor's page, not only Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. We're out there on all forms of media and medium. And we're also doing a lot of different videos, not just myself, but other individuals, so we can highlight with the different programs and
yes.
and the great work that many people in Madison and Jefferson County are doing that need to be commended and recognized for the great work that they're doing for our community.
Oh, this is wonderful. I'm really glad you came in today, because people don't realize what all you all have available. They don't understand what's going on exactly sometimes because of they don't always have the ability to get on social media or onto a website. So this actually helps a lot.
Right. So as I mentioned, I guess in closing, we're working really hard to make sure that we can qualify to get to stage 3.
Yes.
And so I just want to hold this up, that this is going to go up on our website today.
Yes.
This is actually the City of Madison's reopening plan that goes across the different stages. There are 5 stages. And I mentioned we're in the second week of stage 2. We're progressing towards stage 3. And it talks a lot about City Hall and the campground and our parks program and so forth. Crystal Beach, our summer leagues, we're doing everything we can to bring things back to normal.
Right.
But do it safely and consistent with Governor Holcomb's back on track outline. And we're just going to continue to work hard. And we're going to continue to, you know, find things that work well for us that we're going to continue into the future, and hopefully do it in a way that retains all the great things that we've learned along the way. There's been a lot of lessons learned along the way.
Yeah, I think so. Anytime you deal with something unknown, you learn from it as you go.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, this is great, Bob. I appreciate you coming in.
Thanks That's for the invitation.
Wonderful.
Appreciate it.
Anytime. You can come back anytime. So, well, as for you all, make sure you check out their website, and it'll be right here. You'll be able to find it if you go to there. You can actually see on the website all the information you need to know, find the documents you need to see, or the resources that are available in town. And then also, if you have an idea or a suggestion for Mr. Courtney or their staff, make sure you call with a solution. It's really difficult if you call and complain and there's no solution. So if you have an idea and you have a plan, give them a call. Let them know what your thoughts are. So anything else you want to tell them before we go?
812-265-8300. Tammy is standing by to take your call.
She's amazing. Give them a call or let them know what's going on. And as always, we thank you for watching.